I'm speaking with Dr. Andrew Tonkin of Monash University in Melbourne, Australia, a professor of cardiology and researcher, about the results of the Umpire trial of the poly pill. Dr. Tonkin, where does the Umpire trial take us in terms of the development of this new prevention idea?
I think there are two things that are very important about the trial. One of which is the major reasons that patients are not compliant, not concordant with their therapies, which they should be taking, are the costs and the complexity. So it really addresses that issue related to usual therapy. Where the new ground that the Umpire takes us into is the first reported, completed, randomized trial against usual care and in patients who have known atherosclerotic disease. They've already had their diagnosis made of coronary artery disease, ischemic stroke, or peripheral vascular disease. So that really takes us into the area where we show a benefit, albeit a small decrease in systolic blood pressure, a small decrease in absolute terms in LDL cholesterol, but still significant above usual care. So that means it's better than usual care. The other thing which I think is quite interesting is that if anything, the impact is probably minimized by a couple of things about the study. One of which is that it was an unusually high use of medications prior to going into the randomized trial phase. Secondly, a high persistence with usual care. So that is going to probably diminish the impact of what is, you know, what might be the effect of the poly pill in usual practice.
Are there other poly pill studies going on?
There are other poly pill studies that are ongoing. Many of them are looking at people who are apparently healthy but maybe at high risk but haven't had manifest CVD. Very interesting that they're tending to go on mainly in low and middle income countries such as India, other Asian countries, but they're still also in developed countries. North America has had poly pill trials in the US and ongoing in Canada, as well as in Europe and in Australasia.
Can we expect the pharmaceutical industry to lead the way in getting this into clinical practice?
I don't think so, and I don't think that they can be left solely to do that. The reason is that basically the poly pill consists of low-cost generic formulations, and Big Pharma is not interested in taking that forward. There are certain generic companies, such as in India, who do a lot of work in this area, but it's going to be a very low margin that they'll be operating on. And I think, given that a lot of the costs of care, or the costs associated with cardiovascular disease, are related to in-hospital care, already different societies are looking, including in North America and elsewhere, are looking at what they might do to give free medications to people who already have disease. So they'll be very interested in this, and indeed, I think then it becomes a matter of what the regulatory authorities will require. Is it sufficient to have bioequivalence, to have the effects that seen demonstrated here with systolic blood pressure and LDL cholesterol, or do they want large-scale clinical trials? Probably they'll want the large-scale clinical trials to get more data about the safety of its use, although it did appear very good in Umpire.
And I noticed Umpire was sponsored by the EU.
It was sponsored by the European Union. I think it's wonderful that the WHO previously, now the European Union, actually funded and supported the trial, as indeed the World Heart Federation has done. I think they're recognising the need to do something for those huge population masses where people simply can't afford to take their medications.
When are we going to see it in actual clinical use in Africa and other parts of the developing world?
I think it may be earlier than we anticipate. I think that what people will want to see is gain more confidence in the safety data, but it makes rational sense. And then it will depend on the regulatory authorities how much they will require. There are prospectively planned meta-analyses. There are other ongoing phase three clinical trials. I think maybe within 3 to 4 years, we might be starting to see the poly pill in use.